60% of Wisconsin companies have difficulties hiring qualified workers. That's a staggering statistic in itself. 2018, the U.S. will need 1.2 million STEM-trained professionals based on data from the U.S. Department of Commerce. And those are high-paying jobs. What is an engineer earning these days? $50,000, $60,000, $70,000, $90,000 a year. Imagine the impact of not having those jobs filled.
To have the leadership and the Johnson Controls, ITW, executive level leaders engaged in the program is really promising because solving the skills gap is in great part a leadership exercise.
As we look at the escalation of the problem, the skills gap, it's got to go faster. And you know, it's in our self-interest as business leaders, we got to make it go faster. So we've got to take the ball now and build these private public partnerships to really, you know, accelerate the growth of programs that put people in the right, you know, with the right skill set to fill the jobs that we know are going to be there.
If you want to have expanding markets for your products and services, if you equip not only a rapidly growing minority population base, but if you do business with minority suppliers who pay wages and salaries that go to support households, you now have a market that's growing two-dimensionally.
Let's work together. Private-public partnerships are the most effective solutions and most effective manner in which to drive a solution into the marketplace because there's a role for everyone to play. And so it's about collaboration and consortium coming together, and we're deeply grateful for the government partners we already have involved and the leaders who have stepped up to be part of the solution.
This whole conference is about celebrating the American dream. We certainly have to be cognizant of the fact that we have some gaps in skills and gaps in opportunities right here in our own backyard in Milwaukee. So we continue to try to partner with a number of different agencies and organizations and hopefully be able to not only just share some hope, but really share some tangible resources and some tangible teaching, learning, training, and experience to help people build careers, not just get a job, but to really build careers where they can support families, where they can send kids to college, and do all the things that people talk about when they talk about celebrating the American dream.
With us is Carlos Martinez and Jose Hidalgo. Please, a round of applause for us.
We just had this event today, and you saw the product of our success. And it's moving to see these kids say the things that they're saying.
Well, it's a great program here, thanks to our partners, ITW and Miller Electric, American Welding Society, and so many others, Wisconsin Department of Workforce Development, Milwaukee Area Workforce Investment Board, so many more who have all been a part. The City of Milwaukee has been a great partner in this. Certainly through the funding they've provided, they're a partner in the training program. We're now just taking flight in terms of next year, a whole year of execution behind us with great success, about an 86% placement rate.
Well, this has been a very important summit and forum that we've come to. I can tell you that the Hispanic Chamber of Commerce of Wisconsin is really doing a great job on organizing businesses and also bringing businesses here into the city of Milwaukee. Jorge Franco has been at the forefront of making sure that people understand that it's really not you limited by what you do, but it's really about your vision that you can take control of your own destiny. So today, part of the manufacturing community coming together, you heard from corporations like ITW and Johnson Controls really talking about how they're engaged. We've always come together to really deal with the common good of the people here in Milwaukee, especially from the business perspective. We've got small and medium-sized businesses who want to compete, but now they have a forum, and based upon the tools that was presented today, to really become more engaged. And the students who've actually come through this particular program, now employed, setting a precedent for their family, that's really what it's all about. So this has been a great opportunity, and this is the reason why, you know, we, the city of Milwaukee and myself support these initiatives wholeheartedly, and now we need to put our money where our mouth is. To all of the workers, let's shape up, let's get out there, and let's compete. because the opportunities are out here. It's on you to be motivated. It's on you to make sure that you prepare yourself so that you can present yourself to these companies. Because these companies want to hire you, it's up to you to take advantage of the opportunity.